Good morning and welcome back for the next lecture of the hydraulic engineering. In the previous lecture, we had seen about the section factor and convenience factor for the channel sections by considering the Manning's and Chase's equation. Those is to define that, or those is related to the maximum carrying capacity or the vein the discharge, or with respect to which parameters the carrying capacity of the section is related. And which parameters is to decide that purely or geometrical properties, that part we have seen last time. So now we'll go for the next part from the syllabi, from the unit number one, that is about the most economical channel section. The most economical channel section is that channel section which used to pass a maximum discharge with a minimum weighted perimeter. It means that whenever the channel section used to exist, then that channel section we can say that as the most economical if it passes a maximum discharge through that at a minimum weighted perimeter. यानी कि जब पानी पास होता है चैनल सेक्शन में, तब जो भी उसकी पेरीफेरी पानी वेट करता है, भिगोता है, that periphery must be minimum for a particular or that channel section. उस बीच और उसी दौरान हम उसको क्या बोलते हैं, तो उसको हम most economical channel section बोलते हैं. So how come we can say that the when weighted perimeter is minimum, that channel section is so much economical and all those things? क्यों बोलेंगे ऐसा? What is the base for that? So the base for that is nothing but our convenience factor. So convenience factor of the channel section K indicates that maximum carrying capacity or the measure of carrying capacity of the channel. If that measure of carrying capacity is more, then in that case, for that condition, we can say that the channel section is most economical. So the section of a channel is said to be most economical when it passes a maximum discharge for the given conditions of a cross section, roughness, and bare slope. Okay, so the section is also termed as economical if the weighted perimeter of the channel section is less. So how we can say? So from a Chase's equation, that is convenience factor I am going for. From the convenience by Chase's equation. So we are knowing that Q is equals to area into velocity. Then Q is equals to area into velocity as a C root R S naught. Okay, so that is a Q is equals to weighted area A into constant as a C. Into root of R is nothing but the A by P. It is A upon P into root of S naught, we can say. That is a Q is equals to A into, I am taking this A outside. It is a root A, we can say. That is a raised to a 3/2, we can write here in. So power will be A raised to 3/2 into C into root S naught upon a root P, we can write over here in. Okay, by simplification I had written here in, that is a Q is equals to A raised to 3/2. Q is equals to A raised to 3/2 upon a root P, which is nothing but the section factor, we can say root P into C root S naught. It means that if the change is constant and bare slope are constant, then in that case we can say that a Q is directly proportional to the A or inversely proportional to the root P. It is a weighted perimeter. It means that whenever the weighted perimeter will be minimum, the carrying capacity of that particular channel section will be the maximum. And ki jab bhi aapka weighted perimeter ka magnitude kam rahega, tabhi aapka discharge carrying capacity jo hai wo channel section ka, that will be the maximum. No doubt that whenever area, weighted area will be more, in that case that will become an economical. But if area will be more, in that case we can say that the other parameters, that is the cost of excavation and all those things, those will be the maximum. So to instead of that, what we are considering, that is a weighted perimeter. Means that whenever that weighted perimeter P of the channel section is a minimum, then the channel section is able to pass a maximum discharge. And as it is passing a maximum discharge for a given cross section conditions, we can say, that is the area change is constant and bare slope, then that channel section is considered as a most economical channel section. Then that channel section may be rectangular, may be trapezoidal or may be triangular or may be circular or elliptical or anything else. So whenever the weighted perimeter of that section will be the minimum, then in that case that section will be a most economical. Now we will see the condition of a most economical section for a triangular section. What we will do now? We'll go for the firstly, that is for a rectangular channel section, that is the most economical section, or the dimensions of most economical rectangular channel section. That is when to say the rectangular channel section as a most economical. Okay, so consider the rectangular channel section having the base width as a B and a flow depth as a Y. Okay, now as we are knowing the condition as a section is the most economical when the weighted perimeter is a minimum. So I would like to write the various parameters related to that firstly. So weighted area A will be B into Y. I would like to write is equation number one. Then weighted perimeter will be P is equals to B plus 2Y. Okay. And then a hydraulic radius R will be A upon P. That is equals to BY upon B plus 2Y, we can say. This is equation number three. So just now I have written the various hydraulic properties, that is a weighted area, weighted perimeter and hydraulic radius. Now for the most economical condition, for most economical condition, that weighted perimeter must be minimum. P must be a minimum. So when it will be minimum? There will be minimum, that is a DP means a weighted perimeter. Now it is going to vary with respect to flow depth Y. For the given channel section, the base width B is a constant for this particular case. So variable is only Y. It means that you could differentiate that weighted perimeter P with respect to the variable as Y and equating to the zero, you will get the relationship between the B and Y, which is nothing but the which is going to define or which is going to represent the most economical channel condition. It means that dp divided by dy must be equals to zero. Why I am differentiating with respect to y only? Because here we are considering the for a given channel section, the base width b as a constant and the y as a variable. That is y is a changing with respect to the time, we can say. Okay. So now that is a dp by dy is equals to d by dy of weighted perimeter is a b plus 2y is equals to zero, isn't it? So now if you go for differentiating b directly, then with respect to y you will get a zero. But this is related to the y here, we can say b is related to the y. From where? From equation one. If you will consider from the equation one, then we will get the b is equals to a by y. That is a from equation one, I would like to write here, B is equals to A upon Y. Therefore, D by dy of B plus 2Y. Now B instead of the B, there will be A upon Y plus 2Y is equals to zero. Now just differentiating it, that is, what about the differentiation of one upon Y with respect to the Y? What is the differentiation?
Log y.
Instead of the log y, we will take the power as a minus one. What we'll do? We'll take its a power as a one minus one. That is a d by dy of a into y raised to minus one plus d by dy of two y is equals to zero. That is equals to. Now tell me, what is the differentiation of y raised to minus one with respect to the dy? What is the differentiation of y raised to minus one?
Y square.
Minus.
Y square.
Minus one into y raised to minus two, plus two y differentiation will be it will be as it is into one equals to zero. That is a upon y square that will be minus plus 2 is equals to 0. That is a minus a by y square is equals to minus 2. This is a y square. Or I would have to write here only. That is a minus a upon a y square is equals to minus 2. Both side minus sign is there. So minus minus it will become plus. And put the value for the area. Area as a b into y. So area as a b into y, I would like to go for. That equation implies now b into y divided by y square is equals to 2. Okay, minus minus plus. Instead of the area a, now I replaced it by b into y. So 1y will get cancels. That is a b upon y is equals to 2, or b is equals to 2y, we can say. This is the condition for most economical rectangular channel section in terms of the b and y. Or we can write y is equals to b upon 2. Isn't it? Either b is equals to 2y or y is equals to b by 2. If such condition exists for a given rectangular channel section, then that rectangular channel section is the most economical. यानी कि जो भी flow का depth रहेगा, जो भी flow का depth रहेगा, that flow depth must be half of the base width, we can say, or base width must be twice the flow depth. Then and only then we can say that that particular channel section is the most economical, isn't it? So this is the condition for the same. Consider we'll go for this first example, which was asked in May 2017 for 5 marks. So what it says, what data is given and what is asked, that is a rectangular channel of a width 4 meter is having bed slope as a 1 in 1500. Determine the maximum discharge which can be passed from the given channel if a C is equals to 50. So to how to judge that a given channel section is the most economical, that is a first criterion, we can say. So whenever it will be said in an example, that is a determined maximum discharge or maximum carrying capacity or most economical dimensions, then in that case we can say that the given example or numerical is related to the most economical channel section. So here they have asked to determine the maximum discharge, means we have to use here the conditions of a most economical channel section, and the section is a rectangular. Okay, so firstly we'll go for the given data. So one by one we'll write down firstly the given data. So 4 meter, that is a width they had given us. So b is equals to 4 meter. Channel bed slope, that is the s naught, is given as a 1 by 1500. Then c as a 50. C as a 50, and section is a rectangular. So channel section they had given us as an a rectangular. I would like to draw a rough sketch for that. So that this is a total depth of the channel section. Ground level we'll consider, assume that. Then here as a water surface. So depth of the flow as a y and the base width as a b. For the given section, they had given us the magnitude of the base width. Okay. And they are asked to calculate the maximum discharge. So to calculate, Q max passing through this particular channel section. Okay. So now we know Q is equals to area into velocity. Q is equals to area into velocity. We have to use this relation. But for that now, we'll be required to calculate the weighted area A and the velocity, that is average velocity, as a V. So give it as equation number one. So now A is equals to, as weighted area A is equals to B into Y. Now, they had not given us a flow depth y. They have given us only the base width as a b. So how to calculate the y firstly? I will get the y, flow depth y. They had given us only the b as a 4 meters. Will be required
y plus b by 2.
Great. From condition of most economical section, from condition of most economical channel section, what is this condition? B is equals to 2y, isn't it? Is it correct? Whatever I have written over here, or y is equals to b by 2. So put in this equation, equation number 2, I would like to write. Therefore, equation 2 implies area A is equals to b is given. So we'll replace the y. So b into y as a b by 2. That is equals to b as a 4 meters. So 4 into 4 divided by 2. That is weighted area A as how much it is now? Weighted area A.
8
square meters area. Okay. This is 8 square meter. Now, after getting the area in the velocity, now for velocity, average velocity V, we can say as C is given, so we'll be required to go for Chase's formula. So for V by Chase's equation. By Chase's equation, phi is equals to c root r into s naught. Okay, and r is nothing but the a by p. Next line, as hydraulic radius r is equals to a upon p, that is equals to a we have calculated, that is 8. Divided by weighted perimeter as a b plus 2y, that is equals to 8 upon y will be replaced by b by 2. That is a b plus 2 into b by 2. So 2 will get cancels. That is equals to 8 upon b as a 4 plus 4. So that is equals to how many meters? Is hydraulic radius
1 meter.
Great. So now put out the values in the V. So therefore, the velocity V is equals to C as a 50. C as a 50 into root of R as a 1 into S naught as a 1 by 1500. Therefore, velocity V is equals to how many meters per second? 1.29 meter per second. This is the average velocity we can say. Okay. Then go for the discharge. So put in the equation 1. Putting in 1. Therefore, equation 1 implies Q is equals to AV, that is A as a, we have calculated it as 8 square meters. It is 8 into 1.29. Therefore, a Q max passing through that particular channel section is equals to 10.32 meter cube per seconds. This is the maximum discharge or maximum carrying capacity of a given channel section when its a base width of B is a 4 meters. Okay. And the channel bed slope, that is S naught, is a 1/1500. Okay, understood for this? Have you understood?
Yes, sir.
Okay, now we'll go for the next one. Next example we'll go for. So next example, it was asked in December 15 for 7 marks. The statement is like this: a rectangular channel section or rectangular channel carries a water at the rate of 400 lps. Its carrying capacity is given to us, that is a 400 liters per second. When its bed slope is 1:2000, so S naught is given as a 1:2000. Then discharge Q is given as a 200 lps. And what is asked? Find the most economical dimensions of a channel section if a C is equals to 50. Most economical dimensions, it means the whatever the discharge Q is passing through that section is a Q max. So we'll write firstly the given data. So down a given data firstly. Given data Q max is equals to 400 lps. So how many meter cube per second?
10 raised to -3.
10 raised to -3. It's a 400 lps. How many meter cube per second?
0.4 meter cube per second.
It is a 0.4 meter cube per seconds. Okay, so Q max is given. Then channel bed slope S naught as a 1/2000. Okay, and the things those are asked to calculate are nothing but the dimensions of the economical section. Means they have asked to calculate the flow depth Y and the base width B for the given rectangular channel section. In previous example, they have asked to calculate the maximum discharge, that is a Q max, and they had provided us an base width B. But now in this case, in this example, they had given us the maximum discharge, it is a Q max, and they asked to calculate the flow depth Y and the base width B to suit the conditions. Okay, so we'll go for the solution part step by step. Now we know for a rectangular channel, most economical condition kya hoti hai dimensions ke related. For rectangular section, if it is most economical, then what is the relation between its
Y equals to
2B. B is equals to 2Y. Is it correct? Whatever I have written over here.
Yes, sir.
So these things are required to be calculated. So for that, what they had given? They had given a Q max. They had given a S naught. So we'll go for a Q. We know Q is equals to area into velocity. As C is given. C is given, na? That is C is equals to 50. As a C is given, means we have to go for a Chase's equation. That is equals to area A into V as a C root R S naught. Area as a B into Y. It is a B into Y into C into root R S naught. Again, R is a A by P, we can write. Now that is Q is given to us. What is the magnitude for the discharge? I guess it is a 0.4. So 0.4 is equals to, I will replace B by a Y. So that is a B is equals to 2Y. So 2Y into Y into Chase's constant as a 50 into root of R is nothing but the A upon P into S naught as a 1/2000. That is 0.4 is equals to twice y square into 50 into root of area is a b into y, perimeter as a b plus 2y into 1 by 2000. That is 0.4 upon, I would like to take this term towards the left hand side, it is 2 into 50, that is 100. 0.4 by 100 is equals to y square into root of 1 by 2000. I have taken this term also outside, into root of b into y. We are replacing b by the y. That is a 2y into y divided by b as a 2y plus 2y. That is 0.4 divided by 100 is equals to y square into under root 1 by 2000 into root of, what is this now? This will be 2y square divided by, how much it is? Are how much it is?
4y.
So 1y will get cancelled and 2s to 2, isn't it? So I would like to make a vertical column over here. So therefore, 0.4 divided by 100 is equals to y square into root of 1 by 2000 into. So what will be in the root and what will be outside the root? Okay, I would like to go for another one step. That is a y upon 2. Is it correct? Is it correct? Inside the square root is a y by 2?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
0.4 divided by 100 is equals to, now y square into root y. What will the power? Y raised to 2 into y raised to half.
5 by 2.
So y raised to 5 by 2 into root of 1 by 2000 into root of 1 by 2. So now take all those terms towards the left hand side and divide the same. So therefore, y raised to 5 by 2 is equals to, what is the magnitude for y raised to 5 by 2? As per my calculation, I used to get the magnitude 0.57. It is a y, no? 0.57. Rule number 1. Rule number one, is this 0.57 is the y? Okay, that is directly y you have given. So y raised to 5 by 2 is equals to 0.253. Therefore, y is equals to 0.5. What are the next digits? 5, 7. Right, 5, 7, 7 meters. This is the flow depth, we can say. Now calculate the b. As b is equals to 2y, therefore b is equals to how many meters? Just make it twice of the same. It is 1. How much?
1.145.
1.154, na?
Yes,
okay, that is a 1.154 meters. It means that for a given condition of the maximum discharge as a 0.4, channel bed slope as a 1 by 2000, for Chagee's constant as a 50, the most economical dimensions will be y as a 0.577 meter and the b as 1.154 meters. Then and only then this channel section will be able to pass the maximum discharge through the particular, at the particular condition, that is a given value of S0 and Chagee's constant C. Okay.